I took Tyra and my other two siblings in when I was 23 years old. At that time, I had 4 kids. So I'm 23 raising 7 kids by myself. No income from anyone else. No government assistance.
That's
no any of that from anyone. No help from anyone. Not even her, my mom.
That's not true.
My mom was in the streets. So it was either foster care or a family member. At that point, I was the only one who stood up and said, these kids can come live with me. And as far as putting them out, I never put them out. When they would disrespect me, I would let them know, this is something I don't have to do for you. But I did it because I would rather see them in a stable home than no home. Sleeping on the porch, that was her doing. If she came in my house at 1 o'clock in the morning, of course, my doors are locked. At this point, you're a teenager. If I set rules for my household, abide by those rules. The same rules I had for my kids, I had for her and my siblings. I looked at Tyra as being one of my kids, and I raised her with my kids like one of my kids. Every time I did for my kids, I did for Tyra. Every time I did for my brothers and my kids, I did for Tyra. I was up and down, back and forth, school activities, I did that.
That's not true.
Everything you said sounds fine, with the exception of you telling them, throwing up in their face, I don't have to do this. Y'all here because of this. I'm taking care of y'all, and I don't have to do that. That's not something you want to tell children. I know you were young, and hopefully, if you reflect back, you wouldn't have done it, or you won't do it in the future. Don't tell children that. That sticks with them. As you see, it sticks with her and the others that heard it. They think their mother is still the like Mother Mary. They don't care about no dope. They don't care about any of that or whatever the street life she's affected by. That's mama to them. Thank you, big sister, for taking care of us, but we love our mama to death. I had to take care of a relative, and she loved her daddy. Didn't know her mother, but she and still loves her daddy to death. Every time he go on rehab, when my daddy coming out? Time he come out of rehab, I want to move with my daddy. For years and years and years. And we would never talk against him because that wouldn't be right. We would never say, well, your daddy is this, that, and the other. We had troubles with her because of the environment he had her in. But it was never throwing anything up in her face. It was, your daddy's all right with us. He's a good man. He's trying to get it together. Yeah, we love your daddy too. When she acted up, which was a lot, wouldn't try to throw that up in her face. That would have been turning her against her dad. Don't do that. All right, so, but I'm glad to hear you took him in and helped raise him. That's admirable. Most people wouldn't. Most people wouldn't.